G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with the myCOOLMAN 36 litre fridge that they like to call the compact model. This is a really versatile size fridge, ideal for weekends away. You can fit about 47 cans inside, possibly even a great option for tradies to keep in the back of their ute. Now, this guy weighs in about 21.8 kilos, just under 22 kilos, and measures about 65 centimetres in length, about 41 centimetres in width, and just under 43 centimetres in height. We'll do a bit of a tour around the outside, but first some materials. This is a polypropylene, this grey here, so durable polypropylene, durable bump stops on the corners here, and this panel around here is a steel, and that'll line up with an optional battery pack that I'll show you a bit more on shortly. Keep on touring the outside here. This side, not much to see. You've got that metal panel and the vent here where the compressor sits in the bottom. If we flick it around to this side here, we can now see we've got spring-loaded handle. At the top here, those dimensions that I gave you before include these handles. They sit flush. They don't need to be removed if you don't use them. Metal panel runs right around here. And in this end, you've got a 12 and a 24 volt port. Same thing features at the other end. I didn't mention the bottle opener too at this end as well, which is just up in the handle here. Flicking it around once again, not much more to see on this side. You've got polypropylene, a metal panel here, vent where the compressor is, and then this is the business end here where we've got handle at the top, another bottle opener here. The control panel is featured down here, right down where the compressor is. The idea of that is if it's in sitting high in a vehicle, this is still really accessible and readable, sits on a nice angle here, so you're always going to be able to access this panel here. Below that, USB port for charging. It's about a 3000 milliamp hour USB port there. 240 volt power access here and a second 12 or 24 volt power access point here. Now this switch here is emergency override switch. So should something fail with the operation of the panel and everything in here, by flicking this across to the emergency override, it bypasses all of this, puts power straight to the compressor. So the compressor will run in full mode and probably freeze everything inside, but will get you out of trouble should you happen to have a fault inside the fridge. I'll go into a little more on the control panel shortly. First, I want to show you the lid and everything inside. Now the lid's got this little rubber panel on top here, so if you do put things on top, it's not going to slide around too much. It's just a single lid, opens one way lengthways here. Nice big latch here that you lift to open it, and that folds backwards here. Now the lid can come off. It's not reversible. It only hinges from the rear here, but if you were to push back on this, the hinges aren't going to break. There's just a little spring-loaded sort of notch in there that locks up against the metal hinges here. So the lid doesn't break off, it just pops off, but it only goes on one way. Put it back on, bit of a tap, and it locks back in place, and that'll just sit open there. The lid's got this rubber seal around the top here, and that marries up to a little lip that features around the inside of the fridge here. And something myCOOLMAN don't advertise is they use a little bit of the heat from the compressor to run just around this edge here. And what that does is stop this from freezing over. So if you are running this as a freezer, you happen to get a bit of ice creep up here, you're never going to get ice creeping in here. So this seal is always going to seal up against this edge nicely. You're never going to get a situation where cold air is going to escape out because of ice that's built up around the edge. And looking inside here, total dimensions is about 48 centimeters in length from this edge to this edge here, about 29 centimeters. Centimeters in width, and height-wise at the deepest point is about 32 centimeters at this lower point here, and this shelf here that sits above the compressor, you've got about 13 centimeters from the base to the top. You need to take about a centimeter off each side where the baskets sit, because this is a really durably, well, quite a thick material they've used for the basket, so they're nice and strong. Now there's two baskets inside here. One that features flat across the top here, and it has this little lift up panel here, so you can use it flat or you can lift this up and lock that in place, and that gives you access to the deeper port side here. Now I was playing around with this before, and it doesn't fit wine bottles comfortably upright. That's a champagne bottle that fits neatly. A regular wine bottle is just a little bit tall, so you're gonna have to lie your wine bottles down, unfortunately, but they do fit neatly that way. But you can fit your milk cartons in there pretty easily without having to lie them down. So that's probably the most important thing when you're camping, not to spill your milk everywhere if you're taking milk cartons with you. But if you do want to put lots of wine in there, just bear in mind that you can't fit upright wine bottles in this model. Now this basket comes out from the top here, so you don't have to use it, but it does protect the inside of the fridge. Put that aside, and you can see you've now got a basket section here where you can keep things that you don't access as often. That comes out as well, and underneath that, they fit nice and firm, so these don't bounce around. Underneath that, you see you've got a few sort of channels and things, and they lead to a little bung here so that you can easily clean the inside of the fridge out. There is a little LED light at the back here as well that switches on. We'll show you that shortly. And there's about 5 centimeters of insulation around the edge of the fridge here, and it's high quality insulation. So the fridges are designed to be nice and efficient, and it's all powered by myCOOLMAN's own compressor, which is their blue compressor that's featured down here. And current draw on that one's around about 0.8 amps per hour, which is in tested or in controlled environment. So it is really efficient and it's a reliable compressor. It comes from a team who've got a lifetime of knowledge in portable fridge freezers, so you can be confident in the compressor here. Now we're going to power the fridge up here at the moment. Now you do get a few different cables. So you get this little box with your fridge, and you get a 12 volt or 12 and 24 volt cable, which has a cigarette port on the end, and it also can be screwed off to use it as a double pin plug as well, which is a more secure way of connecting it to some power packs, or if you've got that port in your car, or leave that on there so you can connect it direct to a cigarette plug. And you also get a 240 volt cable here, of which I've actually got one already plugged in over here, and I'm just gonna plug that into our fridge now so we can power it up. As soon as we plug this in, we'll see that the light inside the fridge will come on. Control panels come on there. We've got the LED light at the back here, so we've got light inside the fridge so we can see around at night. We'll close that down so the temperature starts to drop. And this will automatically come back on to the last setting that we had it on. It's got a memory. Now we'll talk through the settings or how all this works here. We'll turn it off for starters. So if I hold down on this for 3 seconds, it'll switch off. The light inside the fridge will still stay on. To turn it on, one press, everything lights up. So we've got the internal temperature at the moment. So at the moment it's at 20 degrees. This light here is green, which means everything's okay. This will have multiple settings. If it's flashing or change color, check your user manual, because that will tell you what's going on if there is a fault with the fridge. Now the diamond button here is the turbo button. If we press that, the blue light will come on here, and that's putting the compressor into sort of overdrive. So it's working harder to bring the temperature of the fridge down quicker. Best to use that if you've got it plugged into 240 volts or initially to bring the temperature down. Once the temperature's at the set temperature where you want it, turn the turbo mode back off again, because otherwise it's going to drain your battery much faster. This is showing us the temperature inside the cabinet, not the set temperature, but to change, all the settings are done between this button here. If I press that once, it now goes to the temperature that I want to set it at inside. So this will go right down to minus 22 or up to 10 degrees. So I'm going to set that to zero now. It'll flash. Once it finishes flashing, that means it will be set at that temperature. It's at 20 in there now, but the fridge is working to go down to 0 degrees before the compressor cuts out. Two presses of this button gives us a change between Fahrenheit and Celsius. Obviously here in Australia we're going to use Celsius. Let it flash. Once it stopped flashing, that's gone onto that setting. Three presses of this goes to the battery setting mode. Now your user manual will give you details on what temperature this is going to cut out at, but this is to protect the battery. So the fridge cuts out if the battery drops to a certain voltage. You've got low, medium and high there. I'm going to leave it on the low setting. Wait for it to stop flashing and then it will set at that setting there. Now four presses of this will take us to Bluetooth on or off. At the moment that's on. We can flick it to off. I'm going to leave it on at the moment. Now there is an app that you can download onto Android or Apple phones, so you can do all this or control all these things from the app. To connect your fridge to the app, you hold down on these two buttons together and you'll get the option of either scanning a QR code or scanning for the device with the Bluetooth setting on your phone. So the QR code is up here, so you can scan that for easy connection, or the other setting is to just use your phone to scan for the nearest Bluetooth device and then connect it. Now the last setting I want to show you, and this isn't advertised in myCOOLMAN's manual that come with this, but if there's a factory reset mode, that if you hold down on these two buttons here, it will then go to A, and now this is factory preset to zero. So this means that the temperature gauge on here is accurate to what's inside the fridge. If at any stage you find that it's a little bit out, if you've got a temperature gauge inside the fridge at 18 and this is 20, you can then go hold down on this and say, I'm actually going to move this down a couple of degrees to bring this in line with the temperature gauge that I'm using inside the fridge. So they are factory preset from the factory, but if you do need to adjust it, that is a feature there, but they don't openly advertise that. So that's pretty much all the features of the myCOOLMAN fridge. They're really well set out and really user friendly with the way this is set out at the front here and the location of this panel here. Now There are accessories you can get. There aren't any fridge slides that myCOOLMAN make, but you can attach it to a fridge slide, but use these handles for attachment to a fridge slide. There are feet in the bottom that are attached by screws, but they don't mention taking them out for mounting, and I've not tried it, but they're only small screws, so I'd certainly recommend using these heavy duty handles for mounting. You can get covers for them. This is a cover here for the CCP36 there. A few extra pockets and stuff inside here. It's all functional once you've got it on there, so you can still access all the ports. Adds protection and a little bit of efficiency to your fridge. And the other option that myCOOLMAN have got is their battery pack, which is this one here they've got at the moment. Now, battery technology is always evolving. This is what they've got available at the moment. And this is where this metal panel on the side here is pretty handy. So you can plug the cable that comes with these batteries. Like I said, they are an optional accessory. Cable goes in here and you can plug it into your 12 or 24 volt port here. And there's magnets on the back here that allow you to stick this to the side of the fridge. So you can then take this out of your vehicle, run it from this battery for short periods, and be completely independent of being attached to your car. So just another cool feature that myCOOLMAN have got. I'm sure we're going to see a lot of this type of thing come out in fridges in times to come. That is the myCOOLMAN CCP36. 36 litre fridge. You can fit about 47 cans, they say, inside here. They call it the compact model. Probably a really good all-rounder for, say, couples that are camping, as I mentioned, tradies, or just for a runabout fridge in the back of your car. You can check these out online, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day at snowys.com.au. But if you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest info. Check out some other myCOOLMAN fridges like this one down here.